This video is for entertainment purposes only. It's not to be petty. It's not to bash anyone. It's not to embarrass anyone. It's for entertainment purposes.
Nah, see, bitches.
Even when you're back against the wall, phone keep ringing when no one you can call.
It's your girl back in with another video. And today, I'm going to be telling you guys a story that happened a little while ago, but it's a little interesting. Who hasn't had a fight? Anywho, we'll just get straight into this. I'm just gonna go ahead and let everyone know that this video is for entertainment. This video is for entertainment purposes only. It's not to be petty. It's not to bash anyone. It's not to embarrass anyone. It's for entertainment purposes only. And me and this girl, we have pretty much, you know, let it go or whatever. There's no beef. There's no hatred. There's no nothing. It happened. It's done. Okay. Like your girl was saying, I got into it with this girl. And if I'm not mistaken, it was my ninth grade year. And it was actually at the end of school. Like, we only had like a good 30 minutes left of class. And it was fourth block. It was crazy. It was hectic. But, basically, like, wait, I need to go get a chair. I'm not finna stand up to do this whole video. Wait a minute. So I'm back, you guys. I need to get a chair because who about to stand up for like 30 minutes telling a story with no chair? Not me. Anywho, so like I was saying, I had to be in like ninth or tenth grade. I'm in senior now, so that's how I know it was a while ago. I haven't had a fight since then. I came close, but the Lord delivered me. He carried me out. Yes, he did. I would never get ratchet unless necessary. Okay, so basically, it started prior to, you know, Fort Block. It started in the cafeteria or whatever. It wasn't even my argument, though. Like, I was just... It wasn't even my argument. This was like crazy about it. It wasn't even my argument. Basically, like, okay, anyway, like I was saying, it wasn't even my argument to begin with. I was just sitting with my friends during breakfast before they, before they called us to go to class or whatever, and this girl walked in. And me and her wasn't cool, but it's like it wasn't no real beef. Like, it wasn't like when I see you, it's on sight or nothing like that. Cause it was like cordial. I'm always cordial. Like, I never just start stuff with nobody. Like, even if we argue on like social media or something, like, when I see you, I'm not just gonna be like mugging you or like waiting for you to say something to me. Like, I just don't start drama. Like, you really just gotta piss me off for me to be on that level when I see you. Like, I can get into it with someone one day and then the next day act like it didn't happen. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm just not immature like that. Like, you really gotta piss me off for me to be like that. Like, you gotta piss me off. So, you have to really piss me off for me to get to that point. But like I said, me and her didn't have any beef. It was basically me just being in the middle of, you know, whatever. So we were sitting at the table. She was coming in and she hugged my friend. I'm just gonna call her TT. I'm not gonna say her real name. They call her TT. People who know her know who I'm talking about. Anyway, she came in, she hugged my friend, and then I heard then there was a dude sitting at the table. And I just looked, like, I didn't say nothing. I just looked at her, like, you know what I'm saying? I just looked at my friend, not the girl, you know what I'm saying? I just looked at her, and then our friend, the dude, he was just like, why you hugging her? You know what I'm saying? He just, you know. But he wasn't serious. He was joking. He was not serious. Like, he didn't even have a problem with her. And I guess she took it some type of way, and she just started, like, going off. They got into it or whatever. Look, I'm not just lying. I'm not lying. I mean, I'm not going to say I'm not just lying. I'm not just saying something because, you know, I'm trying to look good or whatever, but I really don't remember saying anything to this girl for her to pretend like she was talking to me. You know, because I just be chilling. Like I said, I do not be on 10 when I see somebody. You gotta really make me mad. So when her and the boy started going at it, I think she said something. She was like, shut the fuck up talking to me, this and this and that. And then he was like, that's how you know it was so long ago. I don't even remember what exactly was said, but basically they were just, you know, going back and forth. And then she said something, and he was like, I get my sister up here to beat your ass. And then he kept on saying, like, I get my sister up here to beat your ass. And then she turned around and she was like, I wasn't even talking to you. And I look back, I'm like, well, who the fuck is she talking to? Talking to me? You know, because I'm the only other person at the table. So I was like, what, huh? And then he looked at me. He was like, oh, she must be talking to you. I'm like, no, she ain't talking to me. She's not talking to me, sweetheart. You know, because, no, we're not even about to do that early this morning. So even though that happened, you know, he was talking, she was still talking. She walked to her little table straight across, and I'm hyped. No, because who the fuck is you talking to? You ain't talking to me. I don't know what went on with you before you got to school, but baby, you need to calm down. Bring it down 3 notches. And rethink it, because you don't want to come to me. I didn't have anything to do with what's happening. So, after all that, I said some words. She said some words. It was left at that. Then everybody on the table started looking over there, and I'm just looking back like, the fuck y'all looking at? You know what I'm saying? Because y'all ain't no bullies. I don't give a damn. So, fast forward, my friend's like, oh, I can't stand it. Bitch, I was somebody beat her ass. He kept on just saying it. I hope, I wish. Needless to say, it happened. It happened. But anywho, so we get to 4 Block, and I sit at the same table as her. 4 Block, literally sat at the same table. Well, it was our seat. It's not like I picked the seat. It was, you know, my friend was over there or whatever too. Well, at least I thought she was my friend. That hoe ain't no friend. Anyways, she was sitting at the table with my best friend at the time. So I sat over there or whatever. And anyway, I sat over there. And I'm not really sure. I know we was all on computers. We all had our little headphones in or whatever. Or whatever, but something happened between them two, and I was like, Raven, just calm. I was like, calm down before I have to, you know. And then she got smart with me. You know, you supposed to be my friend. You got smart with me, and I'm trying to take up for you. She was like, I don't know how to tell me what to do. Okay, baby, don't nobody tell you what to do. Sweetheart, I won't tell you anything, baby. Boo, ma'am. So, the girl had said, oh, you're not going to do nothing. First of all, I didn't even say anything to you. I was talking to my fake-ass best friend over here. I'm trying to defend her. You want to jump your little crunchy hair ass in this conversation? I wasn't talking to you. Okay, let's get that clear. But, like I said, me and her, we squashed the beef. While we are not beefing today, still in 2020, there's no reason to still be beefing with someone from, like, 3 years ago. That's trash. So she just kept talking though, and I don't like to talk. I don't like to argue. I don't like to talk. You either gonna fight or you gonna shut up. That's why when people try to argue with me, they get loud. Like, I just have to be like, when you see me throw my head down, that's me like saying a quick little prayer and coming back to light, because I do not like to be yelled at. I don't like to be disrespected, and I do not like to feel played. So don't ever make me feel played, because then I'm gonna fight. Or don't argue with me, then make me stutter, then I gotta hit you, because you just make me stutter. What's wrong with you? But anyways, I feel like the girl, she just had a whole lot of issues, and I kind of know a reason why she had a problem with me, but I'm not gonna say it, because it is what it is. But she was just, you know, going off at the mouth. She was like, you ain't about that life, you ain't about that life. And I'm just like, who ain't? Because you can't be talking about me, because I'm with it. I'm with it. Do it. Don't do it. So she just kept on talking. Now, talking makes me mad. Talking makes me really mad. So, after me trying to ignore her, listening to my little music, and the song that I was playing, the beat was like crucial. So I'm like already lit over here. You don't want me to just come across that table on you, honey. So she kept talking, she kept saying you about the life. So I stood up. Somebody gonna shut up. It's either me or you. Someone's gonna shut up. So I took my headphones off. I didn't have to do the most, I didn't have to yell. I got up quietly. No one even knew what was going on. That's how you know I'm not an attention seeking asshole. I took my stuff off, got up, walked right around there to her face. I stood there for a few seconds. Now, she had a chance to get up and defend herself. I didn't just run over there and sneak her and attack her. No, I did not. No, I never have to sneak nobody, okay? But anyways, yeah, like I was saying, I got up and I walked around to her, and she just kept saying, you ain't about that life, you ain't about that. I will fold you, literally fold you like a towel. Word to mommy. Nah, bitch, I ain't from New York. But anyway, she kept saying that. So like I said, I walked around to her. Once I walked around to her, it was no stopping me. It was no calming the situation down. And this is how I look back at it. Well, I'm gonna get to that after I'm done telling the story. So basically, she kept saying that, and I didn't say nothing. I was just quiet. I was just looking at her. I was just like, just standing up there like, yeah, it's time to fight. Like, stop talking. Get up. Fight. What's up? And after I said, what's up, she was still sitting there talking about you and about their life. So I show her exactly what I'm about. I hit her. And then it went boom. I blanked out. You know what I'm saying? So I punched her. Like, she fell, flipped backwards in the chair. I don't know how the hell this happened, but the damn table flipped over in the midst of all of this going on and all that. So this girl that I was friends with, she was in the classroom. Not the one that was supposed to be my best friend, but it's another girl that I had just met a few weeks ago. She tried to break it up. Like, she had both of us on the table like this, you know, basically just holding us. And a teacher came in, flying in, and he threw her against the wall. Like, slung her, threw her against the wall. Literally, like, it was a man. And he threw her to the wall. Like, threw her. I'm not over-exaggerating. He slung the hell out of her. I looked at it for a few seconds. I guess the girl thought I was done. I turned right back over, and I got to work on her. And somehow we ended up on the floor. Of course, I was on top. And I was just going in. She started pulling my hair, whatever. You know, I had them little raggedy-ass crochets. Look, you know about to embarrass me pulling these motherfucking crochets on my head. So, I pulled a closure off her cap. I pulled the closure up. there was nothing there, and I pulled a few tracks out, you know what I'm saying? And that was that. I don't pull hair, but if you pull my hair, best believe I'm pulling your hair back. Facts. I'ma pull it 10 times harder than you pull mine, because I don't play the hair pulling stuff. Like, if you want to fight, fight. Because pulling hair ain't doing nothing. We wasting each other time here, so I had to show her. I pulled the closure off, and I pulled a few tracks out. But the teacher, the me and the girl, we fought for a while. Like, the teacher, he was so focused on the girl that he threw, like, he just forgot little poor old girl down here. Like, after he threw her to that wall, she went crazy. Like, she went out in the hall. She went crazy. I swear, she went crazy. Like, it wasn't no standing to her. She was cussing everybody up. But the girl, I don't know what she did. Somehow she scratched my contact out of my eye. One of my contacts was gone, you know what I'm saying? When I got up, but this is what pissed me off. This is what made me beat her even harder. Like, this is what made me beat her even harder. The fact that somehow her feet ended up in my face. Like, you know how somebody trying to, like, kick you off of them? Her feet ended up, like, right here. And I just smelled like a woo. I got so mad. Cause she didn't have no socks on. I don't even know how I beat her out of shoes. I don't even know how her shoes came off. But she started kicking me. And I was just like, I climbed right back up to that face and started wearing her out. Don't ever put your feet in my face. Ever. You know what I'm saying? So, that right there, baby. I do not like funk. None of that. Don't put your feet in my face. That is so disrespectful. That's so nasty. I had to be right back to that. So, she was like, fucked up. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. She was fucked up. It was blood right here. I don't know if it was top or bottom tooth, but one of the teeth were gone, like, gone. It was, you know, blood. It was just blood. It was bad, and eventually I did feel bad, but at the time, I was, like, so angry and so many emotions were going through my head, I didn't care. But after the fact, like, I really felt bad. And I just told myself, like, no more fighting anymore. And especially, like, you know, me. That's why I try not to fight people, because I already have, like, anger issues. And you don't want me to take everything I go through out on you. Because that's painful. And she can vouch. I'm not going to ever fight anyone. While I'm angry, I'd rather walk away, let them talk, whatever they want to do. I'm not going to fight anyone angry again. Like, even though that kind of doesn't make sense, because the only way you fight someone is if you're angry. But that's a different type of angry, and I'm not going to do that. So, yeah, so finally the teacher came back and broke us up. I'm not even sure if it was the same teacher, but it was teachers already in there. It was a teacher in there already, and she just looked. She was not feeling like that fighter. She called the teacher that threw her friend to the wall. She called him in there. I don't even know where he went. He disappeared for a good 3 minutes, because I was beating that girl up for a while. Like, it was crazy. And when they finally pulled me off, somehow they grabbed me, and I could not breathe. Like, the way they grabbed me, I just couldn't breathe for some reason. I just could not breathe. I was just like, I couldn't speak or nothing. Like, I was just like, what the fuck, you know? I just felt, like, really winded. I don't know why I felt like that, but when he let me go, it was like I caught my breath back. I was like, oh, what the fuck he was doing, but, you know, because I blacked out anyway. And when I got up, I was talking my shit, and I was like, yeah, I busted your this and this and that, and, you know what I'm saying, she didn't really have much to say. She didn't say anything. And then they try to take me through the back, because the classroom is like a lab, through the back door, and then there's an exit, like, to go to the hallway. they took us two separate ways. They took her to a whole nother building, like, because we have two or three different buildings on the campus. They took her out of the building that I was in, like, completely out. And they took me to the principal's office, of course. So, I mean, yeah. They took me to the principal's office, and she was just asking me what was going on and stuff. And I told her exactly what was going on. I told her this was coming. And then this is the first thing they say, well, why didn't you tell anyone? Why would I tell y'all? Why? I'm not finna tell y'all nothing. What y'all gonna do? Huh? Nothing. Anyways. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, then I got sent to ALC, basically alternative school, for I don't really know how long I was there. I think like a month, no, 2 or 3 months. It was probably for the rest of the school year. I don't know how long I got sent over there, because I was over there for a little minute. But I missed out on a lot of stuff. I regretted that. I ruined the reputation. You know, that's the year that really made me open my eyes. Like, girl, this is not worth it. This is not worth it. You know what I'm saying? So, I had to stop doing that stuff that I was doing and get right, because it wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth the name that I was making for myself. But, yeah. Basically, me and her, you know, we never saw each other for a while after that. I saw her at a game. That was over a year after the fact. Like, she didn't come back to school. She didn't come to ALC. She didn't, none of that. Like, and that's what made me feel really bad, because I never want to be labeled as a bully. I don't want to be labeled as anything like that. You know, because that's not who I am. It's just I let someone's words get the best of me, and I regret it. It was not worth it. It was not worth everyone coming up to me, asking me about it. No, I actually started to get a little irritated, because I'm like, damn, that's all y'all know me for? So, yeah. I didn't fight anymore after that. I mean, you know, it's my 12th grade year, and I still haven't gotten to a fight. So, yeah. Anyways, thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe. Get me to 100 subscribers. It's only 4 people. Come on. It does not take much out of you to click that red button. Period. Without further ado, make sure you leave a like. Make sure you comment what you want to see next. And goodbye. I'm out. See you later. Mwah.